This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, this is video one of graphing the cotangent function. We're going to graph the basic function y equals cotangent of x. You should have already watched the videos on how to graph the tangent, y equals tangent x. We're going to start the same way. Just a reminder of how we computed the tangents. I just used a calculator and put what all the values are, and we found out the tangent has a period of pi. And the reason when I graphed the tangent function I went from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2 is so that my asymptotes were at the beginning and end. Okay, so it's an easier way to do it. We're going to do the same thing for cotangents. I went ahead and found all the cotangents. Those are actually the reciprocal of the tangents, right? Because remember, cotangent is x over y, tangent is y over x. So if you take all the reciprocals, these are the values you get. But notice where it's undefined for the cotangent. Since it's x over y, like for instance right here at 0, x over y is 1 over 0, which is undefined, right? So it's undefined at x equals 0 and also at x equals pi. It's positive, it's undefined, and it starts going down. It's positive until you get to 0, and then it's negative until it's undefined again. And this is not supposed to be a negative sign here that I accidentally got there. And then it's positive again, it starts repeating. So just like the tangent function, the cotangent function has a period of pi units. And when we graph it, we're going to start and go from 0 to pi, as opposed to going from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2 is with the tangent function. It's just because it's easier to see the full graph that way. So again, I'm just putting the values I got on the previous screen here. And since I have all these different fractions, I decided to just make each of these little spacings marks on the x-axis in 12. So you can see pi over 12, 2 pi over 12, 3 pi over 12, 4 pi over 12, 5 pi over 12, 6 pi over 12, etc. And then I just wrote the reduced things here, so it's easy to plug these in. So first of all, notice it's undefined at 0 and pi, and so I've got my dotted graphs right there where you could see it. And let's see, well, where does it start at pi over 6? Well, it starts at 1.7. Okay, so at pi over 6, it's up here at 1.7. Pi over 4, it's at 1. Pi over 3, it's at 0.6, getting down. And at pi over 2, it's 0. That's where it goes to the x-axis, at pi over 2. 2 pi over 3 is negative 0.6, about right here. 3 pi over 4 is negative 1, about right here. And 5 pi over 6 is negative 1.7. So what happens here is it starts up, goes through 0, 0, and then goes down. Oh, it's a really bad graph. Sorry, because I've really spaced it out. I'll draw a little bit better one on the next page. But that is one period, if I drew it a little better, one period of y equals the cotangent of x. Notice something different. It starts up at the left and goes down, whereas the tangent function, if you recall, goes up. Just like my page wants to go up. Okay, so we're graphing y equals the cotangent of x, and the period is pi. The range, all real numbers, because it goes all the way down forever and all the way up forever. Remember, these asymptotes are guidelines. What are the vertical asymptotes for this one? Well, it's at 0 and at pi. Well, which of those is easiest to write first? 0. You could write x equals 0 plus, and then remember we have to do the full period. Well, a period is pi units to get to the next one. So if you start at 0, the next asymptote is going to be pi units away, pi k. Well, there's really no reason to write 0 plus pi k, so we could just write pi k. Just pi k, where k is an integer. And that'll give us all our vertical asymptotes. Now, of course, this would change if the whole graph had been shifted left or right, if there was a phase shift, or if there was a vertical, if it went up or down. But as long as it's just cotangent of x or cotangent of 5x or something like that, or 3 times the cotangent of x, in other words, there's no phase shift or vertical shift, it'll, 0 will be one of the asymptotes. And then whatever the period is, you would add to that to get to your next asymptote. All right, so this is what this usually looks like. Okay, not terrific. So what we say is over here is pi, that's an asymptote. The guidelines are right here. Right in the middle, which is your pi over 2, is where it's going to be a 0, 0 this time, because the asymptotes are in between 0 and pi, and it just starts up first. All right, so where are the guidelines? It's in between right here and right here. It starts up and goes down. So that's what you have to remember. It's the cotangent, starts up and go down. Of course, if you forget, just plug in some numbers and you'll be able to see it. So that's a basic graph of the cotangent. So this is the basic graph of y equals cotangent of x. And just so you remember what it looks like for tangent on the same graph, remember the tangent, it went through 0, 0, and we went in between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. It started down, and it went up. Okay, so that's the graph. It's kind of confusing looking at them on the same graph. So their asymptotes are in different places. The tangent starts down and goes up, unless of course you're doing minus tangent of x, and the cotangent starts up and goes down. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.